This week, I've got Booksmart, which is a hilarious comedy that happens to be the directorial debut of actress Olivia Wilde. And I'm going to make a super bad comparison here because it's just the easiest thing to do, because it's about two best friends and they are more academically inclined than party inclined. And so they go most of high school or all of high school without really going out and socializing and partying. And, you know, they're class president, salutatorian, valedictorian, all this stuff, but they haven't really kind of spread their wings on the social front. So they decide last day of school, we're going out, we're going to go to like the biggest party in town. So it's one of those like takes place over the course of ridiculous night movies, which is, you know, I'm not gonna lie, I like the format. And the other reason it's really easy to make a super bad comparison is because it stars Beanie Feldstein, who is Jonah Hill's sister. It also stars Kaitlyn and I think the chemistry between the two of them is just so fantastic. It's so nice to see like a strong female relationship. They're supportive. Like, you want that friend, like whichever one you identify with more, you want the other one to be your friend in real life. Like, you want someone to be your cheerleader and your best friend and your confidant and someone to challenge you and all this stuff. I just felt like it was a great representation of actual female friendship. And then the other thing I love is that they get to be funny and like kind of gross funny and hilarious funny and things that you wouldn't bat an eye at if a guy said it. I felt they did it in such a clever and careful way where, yeah, it's kind of gross out and it's raunchy and just absurd. I'm so grateful that they found a way to kind of break into that market and make it funny. And I think like any gender audience or any identity, you know, any way you identify, you're going to appreciate this film, because ultimately it's just a story of friendship and a story of, you know, young romance and wanting to fit in. And I will say also, this film is full of just like famous families. So Billie Lourd, who is Carrie Fisher's daughter, plays this like, you know, crazy ethereal girl from school. Cuba Gooding Jr.'s son is in it, playing the boy that, you know, all the girls lust after. I also really appreciated that they're just super, like, have a super modern approach to sexuality and feminism. And I really appreciated that Kaitlyn Dever's character was gay, because they approached it in a way that didn't feel like tokenizing her sexuality, in that you don't necessarily see a ton of like comedies or even romantic comedies or stuff like that about younger people. Like, I think the only one I can remember is like Love, Simon in the last few years, where you're just like, yeah, no, you're like a fully formed character and you just so happen to be going through the same issues that the other characters are going through in terms of like, oh, I have a crush on this person. Oh, do they like me back? Like, oh, I'm inexperienced, this and that. I just found this movie so funny and so absurd. If you're a fan of Superbad, if you're a fan of, actually, I want to say like Bridesmaids, where it's just like a strong female comedy, if you're a fan of any of those things, this is going to be a great movie for you. It made me simultaneously like miss high school a little bit and also realize I'm so, so glad I'm so far removed from it. So Booksmart, it's just super funny. Definitely go see it. I'm going to give it 4 out of 5. The other film I have this week is called All Is True, and it is directed by Kenneth Branagh, and it is about the life of William Shakespeare, which is slightly different since he usually is just starring in Shakespeare stories. It also stars Dame Judi Dench, who is one of my favorite actresses of all time, and Ian McKellen. So you've got these super powerhouse British actors who know Shakespeare like no other, but that doesn't necessarily mean that they're capable of making Shakespeare himself story compelling. And it's super bizarre. Like, I feel like ultimately, it's actually a family drama. Like, that's what it comes down to. It follows Shakespeare when he is successful. And basically, Shakespeare, not a great guy, honestly. Like, not a terrible person, but like not the most relatable character, obviously. And a lot of the story revolves around the fact that he only has two daughters surviving. He had a son who passed away when he was young. Especially at the time, women weren't exactly like gonna pass along the lines. He was concerned about his legacy, this and that. And I don't think he thought very highly of his daughters, which is disappointing. Accurate for the time, I'm sure, but still disappointing. And it's bizarre to see, you know, a modern film, even if it's trying to be historically accurate, kind of take this approach. And then, you know, they try and rectify that. They try and make it seem like he becomes enlightened and you know, is appreciative of his daughters through the course of the film. But really, I was like, this is ultimately just a family drama that happens to be about a famous family, but it's really just an excuse to recite random Shakespeare bits. And it feels shoehorned in. Like, you could have made this film about pretty much anybody at that time, probably, like, who was successful or who was whatever, like, and not had the Shakespeare parts, and it might have been as compelling, if that makes sense. Like, it just was bizarre in that you can tell that Branagh is a super fan of Shakespeare, but that doesn't mean the rest of us are going to be. And there's nothing about the character that he forms in this film version of it that makes me go like, yes, I'm so grateful to know this much more about William Shakespeare, the man who defined theater history. I don't even think if you were like a super Shakespeare fan, you would love this movie, because it's like, it you know, it peppers in the Shakespeare history, facts, prose every once in a while, but it's also just like a you know, sometimes almost feels soap opera-ish in terms of drama. And then the changes in characters come about so quickly that you're like, what was this compelled by? Like, Shakespeare himself would have been disappointed in the way the characters developed through the course of this film. So unfortunately, I'm only going to give it 2.5 out of 5.